Thank you. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. And we pray. In holy baptism, Frank was clothed with the robe of Christ's righteousness that covered all his sin. And St. Paul says, do you not know that all of us who have been baptized into Christ were baptized into his death? And we were buried, therefore, with him by baptism into death, in order that just as Christ was raised from the dead by the glory of the Father, we too might walk in that newness of life. For if we have been united with him in a death like his, we will certainly be united with him in a resurrection like his. And we pray. O Lord God Almighty, God of grace and love, we give you thanks for your loving kindness shown to Frank and to all your servants who have finished their course in faith. Now rest from their labors. Grant that we also may be faithful unto death and receive that crown of eternal life through Jesus Christ, your Son, our Lord, who lives and reigns with you in the Holy Spirit of God, now and forever. Amen. From the movie, Oh Brother, Where Art Thou? And picked that out because Frank fishing in the river. John 14:1-3. Let not your hearts be troubled. Believe in God. Believe also in me. In my Father's house are many rooms. And if it were not so, I would have told you that I go to prepare a place for you. And if I go and prepare a place for you, and I will come again, and I will take you to myself, that where I am, you may be also. Gospel of our Lord. Now you can turn to your hymnals. They're in front of you. 801. hymn 801, How Great Thou Art. Grace, mercy, and peace to you from God our Father and the Lord and Savior Christ Jesus. His name and rich love. Amen. Bye, family, and all those that are here with you today, gathered together to remember and to share. Jeff and I. The first thing you said to me, bye, was 67 years. 67 wonderful years, and it meant a great deal, and you'll remember those, yeah. Thank the Lord God Almighty that he blessed so richly for all those times and all those years. I remember the time when I went visiting the garden, the huge garden, and you two were in there together, having it grow. I've seen pictures about travel and places that you were at and go, and good times and all the wonderful years and memories. And Jeff, you shared that with your dad. Was there to support both and to encourage both in sports and in band and especially fishing. Taught you in how to live life and appreciate it and to appreciate fishing. And you said he was very patient, very understanding, kind, just always there. Yeah, the fish he shared, and he showed, you see all the pictures, and you'll see them in the narthex, and all the years, and all the times. Frank's got some fishing buddies that are here today, and that he shared a lot of times with, and family, and the members here at Faith, that knew Frank and I so well, and Frank, in his eternal glory. I just always remember seeing the boat hooked up and going fishing. And he would talk about the places that he, the lakes and going. And he would talk about the fish sometimes. But he never boasted. He was never proud. He didn't take fish from here to here, ever. But he had caught a lot of fish through the years. Amazing and wonderful. A servant of the Lord. Ice fishing when he couldn't go in the summer. And I look at the lake. There's a picture that you'll see that he's got this casting rod through the ice, and he's all excited because he's pulling it up, and on the end is a little perch. Love fishing. Loved family. And I shared that love with you for all those years and time. Get to see and experience and know God's creation. Frank and Tim used to get together at the social hall after service and talk fishing. Frank was a man of God, a true servant. The early church records have you, I, Frank, charter members, inception of the church, before it was ever here, before it was ever anywhere. What the church should be and what the true church is. Frank, with the company, used the backhoe. And this whole area of the church is leveled off because Frank hauled that dirt from that pit down there and brought it up here so that the church could be leveled and put in place. And then when the contractor was here and reviewing the plans, Frank was the one that dug the backhoe, dug the foundation and the footings. And you shared that the contractor looked at Frank with you and said, he's good at that. He was an usher here and was made sure everything was in place and the schedules were out and things were in order. you here, and you and him were here worshiping many times and through the years, and I just always look forward to seeing that we'll see you. I and Frank would separate the bulletins in the back at the end of the service so that they would be, the music would be separated and saved. Yeah, thank you for all the years and all the times. Whenever we called, Frank would bring his tractor up here and help with the church when the tree had fallen and needed help. Call Frank, and he was here. Pull the branches away, pull up the stumps. He just said, well, what else can I do? How else can I help? He was one that we called to push all the branches in back into that pit area with after they had gotten too high and too much. Call Frank, and he will be here, and he will push that all back into a big pile so that we can still use it again. The youth group needed firewood one time, and we collected all the wood, and it was there. But then what? All that was mentioned was that there was a firewood that needed some work, and Frank said, I'll bring my log splitter up. And he took the time and cared enough to help the youth have all that wood split. And he operated his splitter and said, what else can I do? How else can I help? A true servant of the Lord. And we thank him for the time he spent in the service on our behalf. Frank always had a smile. He was always laughing, always enjoyed life. And he was a dear member of the church, and you always have been and always will be, too. You've got family, you got connections here. I heard about your classmates, and you got family and friends and loved ones here. And trust in that. The Lord will carry and sustain you through it all and will lift you up. Some of the last years were not always that easy. And you were there. The Lord gave you strength, gave you courage, gave you his peace in the midst of all that time. Last time I talked to Frank, met him in the grocery store, wherever you were. And talked to him for a little while. Had a nice visit. And we talked a lot of things. And I offered to say, Frank, if you need help with cleaning up the property and help with the wood. And the first thing he said to me was, if you would like some wood, come and get it. Come help yourself. You're welcome to it. Now we know Frank's soul is in his eternal rest in God's heaven. And that day when Christ Jesus will come again will be the resurrection and life, the true life. A servant of the Lord, and we thank and praise him for receiving his eternal glory. A true servant of the Lord. And yes, we do grieve. And we know hurts, but we also know rejoicing and celebrating because we know a risen Lord. Count among his saints and waiting for that day of the glorious body and the immortality. I kind of joked one time in God's new kingdom with the river of life and the tree of life. Whether Frank might ask God if there's some fish in that river. With his saints. Revelation chapter 7, 9 through 17. After this, I looked in a great multitude that no one could count from every nation, every country, every tribe, every language, stand before the throne. And a lamb, clothed in white robes, was before them. And they had palm branches in their hands and crying out with a loud voice, "Salvation belongs to our God, who sits on the throne and to the Lamb." And to all the angels were standing before the throne and the elders and the four living creatures, and they fell down and they worshiped the Lord. And they were saying, "Blessing and glory and wisdom and thanks be giving and honor and power and might be to our God forever and ever. Amen." He said, "Where are these, those that are standing here? They've come out of great tribulation, washed with robes and blood of the Lamb, and they're before his throne night and day. And they shall never hunger again, and they will not thirst, the sun will not strike on them a scorching heat, and the Lamb will be in the midst, and he will be on the throne, and he will be their shepherd, and he will guide them to the spring of living water, and God will wipe away every tear from their eyes." Thank God Almighty that we have that joy, we have that celebration, we have the newness of life in him. And we have that courage, we have that strength, we have joy and peace that he gives to you and all of us. Christ Jesus, Lord and our Savior. And the life that he gave to Frank, and now eternal salvation. What joy and celebration we do have. In Jesus' name, amen. Second Timothy 4:7, right? "I have fought the good fight. I have finished the race. I have kept the faith." He had kept the faith. And you have that faith too. And all of us have that faith in Christ Jesus and that joy and peace. As Pastor Human is standing, God our hearts and minds in him. In Jesus' name, amen. Amazing Grace, number 744. Thank you. And we joined together in prayer. Almighty God, you knit your chosen people together in one communion in the mystical body of Christ Jesus, your Son, our Lord. Give to your whole church in heaven on earth your light and your peace. Grant that all of us who have been baptized into Christ's death and resurrection may die to sin and rise to newness of life, and that through the gate of death and the grave we may pass with him to our eternal resurrection. Grant to us who are still in our pilgrimage that we walk yet by faith, and your Holy Spirit may lead us in holiness and righteousness all our days. Grant that all who mourn and grieve today in your loving care, casting all of their sorrows on you, that they may know the consolation of your love. Give courage and faith to all those that hurt today, that they may be strengthened in the days ahead in the assurance of the holy and certain hope of the communion of your church, in the joyful expectation of eternal life with those they love who have departed into the faith. God of all grace, you sent your Son, Jesus Christ, our Lord and our Savior, to bring life and immortality to light. We give you thanks that by his death he destroyed the power of death, and by his resurrection he opened the kingdom of heaven to all believers. Strengthen us in that confidence that because he lives, we shall live also, and that neither death nor life, nor things present nor things to come, will ever be able to separate us from the love which Christ Jesus our Lord has for us, who lives and reigns with you and the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever. Amen. And the peace of the Lord Jesus Christ be with you now and always, in Jesus' name. Peace of the Lord be with you now and always, in Jesus' name. Spend time together. Before the God's blessing.